We'll start a car club. We'll call it the struggling car club. I'm struggling right now because I'm going so fast that I'm not doing enough wow practice, and the panic is starting to set in, and this is leading to too much nervousness and get kind of a cold-like symptom. It's all because I didn't put tremendous emphasis on the wow. That's it. So I need to do a better job. That's all there is to it. And so I'm continuing to at least try here. Welcome to the Apex Yoga 217 Intensive. Apex Yoga is all about making some key distinctions, very clear distinctions, just a few key clear distinctions. Okay, that's what it's all about, because that's all that's necessary. What the problem with the world right now, our struggle is that the world is hell-bent on trying to blur those distinctions. That's all the world has to do to keep the ball rolling through transmigrating through doubt. Imagine doubt. That's what the cycles, conditioned existence, the cycles of reincarnation, all this. We're just transmigrating through these, sloshing through a swamp of doubt is basically all we're doing. Sloshing through a swamp of doubt. But it's imaginary doubt. It's our own attempt to cast doubt on reality, but it's all make-believe. It doesn't really exist. Did you know that the future, what we call the future, is just looking at what we think is a past? There can't be a future unless there's a past. Do you know that? There can't really be a future. So when we think of a future, we're automatically referencing the past. Amazing. I saw that today. He said, that's what Jesus is talking about. Of course, it's so simple. It's so simple. There's a clear distinction right there. Okay, very clear distinction. Oh, okay, I see what's really going on. Well, the world is trying to blur that. If we blur it, we're still in doubt. We're still in so much doubt. So clarity is all important. Clarity is all important. And what I'm saying right now is the world is really running amok. The monsters are running amok. It hits you from every possible angle, it seems like, right now. So Apex Yoga is just a refuge where we just focus on a few clear distinctions, just a few clear distinctions, with a tone of certainty about it, and keep the tone of certainty going. Speaking about a tone of certainty, I have a Beach Boys CD here I'm playing. What is this one? I think it's I Get Around. I get around, round, get it. I get around town to town. Yeah, there's a tone of certainty. I was just listening to beginnings of like Surfer Girl and then Catch a Wave. It just Catch a Wave came out. Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world. Like boom. I was like, whoa. And I remembered hearing that back in the 60s, and how it just struck me, it was so much certainty in their singing. They were so confident in their singing. And that just vibrated with me. It just knocked me out. The Beach Boys knocked me out because they were so certain about their music. And I've never heard anything like it, and still haven't. The Beatles were very talented, very clever, very savvy, very musical, very talented, all of that. But they can't hold a candle to the Beach Boys in terms of the sound, because when that there's no intros and outros like the Beach Boys. The Beatles, not in the same class at all. And it shows right now. It shows to this day. Hearing that Catch a Wave. Boom, boom. Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world. It's just like, boom, resonates. That's all you need to hear. That's all I need to hear. Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world. Catch a key distinction and you realize there is no world. To sit on top of the world means to realize there is no world. There really is no world. Set the world free to reflect back to you that there is no world. Okay? Set the world free and give it permission to reflect back to you the truth that there is no world. There is no world. This is a very key distinction of Apex Yoga. There is no world. One of our key tenets, the supreme adept of the Apex Yoga approach, is Longchenpa. All right, and he has some buddies like Padmasambhava, Manjushri, Jemyen Kenzi, Choki Lodro, etc. Okay, but he is regarded as the supreme adept of Apex Yoga, which transcends really all graduated progressive approaches and we just keep making these key distinctions so we can see, this is true and this other is not true. That's all. But very few in the world are able to do this because of the erosion and spiritual erosion that's taking place throughout the ages. You know, when Jesus left, he says, I'm coming back. That put people on notice, and they were cautious. Okay, it was brilliant strategy by Jesus. They said, we better mind our P's and Q's and not start undermining what Jesus told us we need to pay attention to, because he could be coming back any moment. We don't know when he's coming back. But over the last couple thousand years, people have gotten kind of more and more blasé about it, until we're in the present time when most people don't give it even a first thought, let alone a second thought. But I still give it thought because he came back with A Course in Miracles, which, you know, and you don't know what he's going to do next. He may show up today. So I'm on high alert. You know, it's very good to, it sort of blocks people from meddling with his teaching. It really makes them think twice, saying, hey, I mean, Jesus could come back today. So when Jesus said, yeah, I'm returning. When things get bad in this world, you look for me, I'll tell you what the signs are, and I am going to return, so you better get ready for that return. And he told us over and over again how we have to get ready and how important it is to get ready. Very brilliant, very wonderful approach like this. And to some degree it worked, but it's people, again, have gotten, they finally think, Jesus, he's not returning, so we don't have to worry about him. Yeah. And they've relapsed. We live in a time of extreme relapse. Jesus said that during these times it would be the worst, darkest time ever, and even the saints would be in danger of relapsing back into doubt, belief in doubt, trying to perfect doubt. And we're at that time right now. So it's really almost too much for me, because they're just, people cannot bring themselves right now. Their attention can't get it in the right place. They just can't, because of the super fragmentation and distraction of attention. This is what I said is taking place, and I warned everybody, you must pull away from all this. They didn't heed the warning, and now their attention, they can't put it in the right place. And not being aware of this, they then might blame you, say, well, you're no good anyway, you don't know what you're talking about, that kind of thing. You don't know anything. That means I can't, what they're really saying is, I can't put my attention where it needs to be, and it's your fault. it's not my fault, because I have done everything possible to encourage everyone to put it in the right place. So that projection really doesn't work when it's turned in my direction. But I can feel the effects of it. You know, it's really getting me down. It seems like, you know, hopeless right now, because the attention. But attention, the fog can clear up if we get ourselves away from the vast machinery of distraction. Let the attention settle. Have to let the attention settle. Now, it's been difficult in California because all the hype about the weather. And speaking of that, there's another really, really strong atmospheric river event coming into California for the next 8 days. What I see is going to be very wet again here. So we're all shaky already about all the road closures. People, so I said, "How are you going to get home?" I said, "I don't know." To Santa Cruz, this road's blocked. This road, over 100 roads have been affected in the mountains, and then the dam issues and all of this. And so we're like saying, "Oh, it's like doom is like on the horizon." I could use a break from California to tell you the truth right now. I really could. I really could use a break. Honestly, I tell the Dharma Kings that. I always tell them that. Well, what's some good news? The good news is, as we prattle on with the tone of certainty and the easy confidence that there's only a few little distinctions we need to make, just a few, one insight settles it all. This is true. One insight settles it all. So we're not grasping at straws here. We know what the insights are. We just have to get our confidence, more and more certainty and confidence in them, and more familiarity. So the good news is my knee isn't worse after I did a lot of workout yesterday and the last 3 days, I believe, and swinging a golf club, a driver, really hard, quite a few times, quite a few times. I thought, oh boy, here's the big test. Because I told the Dharma Kings are telling me you got to lay low and go play golf. And I said, look, my knee is killing me. I can't play golf with this knee. And then I was told stay away from the beach. So I have. And lo and behold, my knee has gotten a lot better. I've gotten massive warnings to stay away from the beach. So much so that I've actually done it. I said, man, I just can't keep ignoring all these events and dreams and holy cow. It's astonishing, how much emphasis on this. And so I'm staying away. The knee is getting better. It's still some instability inwardly, side to side kind of instability. And it's still, a little tender, a little painful, a little sore here and there. But it didn't get worse. It didn't swell up after swinging that golf club real strongly. So I said, wow, maybe I can play golf. And then I practiced chipping yesterday for the first time in years, maybe practice chipping. And I did really well. I got the knack of it real quick. I said, and I was doing really, really good. And I said, wow, that's really great. Putting, I have a feel for it. The chipping, I have a feel for it. The short irons, I have a feel for it. So now I'm swinging a driver and my knee seems to be holding up. So, I mean, that for me, that's tremendously great news because I put all my faith in the Dharma Kings. I said, you're telling me I got to go in this direction. My knee's telling me that it's futile, but I'll just put my faith in you and I'll do it. I'll go in that direction anyway and just have confidence that the knee is going to heal up and everything's going to be fine. That's what I did. Just faith, tremendous faith, and so far so good. I've been exercising a lot. I'm tired. I'm really tired. Really tired. I'm so frazzled with what's going on. Just not feeling well at all. Can't sleep well. Just shaking like a leaf sometimes and working so hard. It's just we're in transition right now. So, but a break from California, oh, that'd be pretty nice, especially the Bay Area. God, we could all use a break from the Bay Area, couldn't we? Yeah, we could. I can give myself a break from Hollywood, which I have for the last maybe 30 years. It's just great because just don't watch any movies, don't watch any entertainment, pay no attention to it whatsoever. But when you live in a place, how do you take a break from it? It's not so easy. I might have to figure out a way to do it. But anyway, we don't know what could happen. Lot of positives are happening right now, but negatives too. As I say, the help outweighs the problem. The help is always greater than the problem. problems. The help is always greater than our problems. This is another key tenet of Apex Yoga. The help is always greater than the problems. Always. So we pay attention to the help. We don't need to pay attention to the problems because we know all we have to do is pay attention to the help. That's the end of the problems right there. That ends the problems. The help is greater than the problems. Now, my good friend needs help right now. My very good friend needs help. We wished him happy Valentine's Day yesterday. We got a text back saying he has third stage going on fourth stage cancer of the lungs. Just diagnosed. I mean, he was coughing. Got an x-ray. They said, well, there's something there. Got an MRI and immediately chemotherapy. Just like that. I mean, it happened boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. So fast. So fast. I mean, imagine this. It's just, you start having coughing fits, you go to the doctor, they say, well, I'm not sure what's wrong, but you know, we'll take an x-ray, then the next thing you know, next test, and then suddenly oncology doctor says, oh, well, you've got third stage cancer of the lungs. Wow. He's a beautiful soul. Beautiful soul. Wise soul. You know, the world would be a much poorer place without him. That is for sure. So, yeah, maybe this kind of shocked me. We just got the text back. You know, hey, and my breathing is slowing down. You know, it progresses very fast at this stage, apparently. Now, of course, nothing is actually happening. First of all, you can say everything is reversible because everything is just free in the moment. So it's just an appearance, is all it is. That's why Jesus healed instantaneously. Your faith made you whole. Boom. I understand this, but most don't. Most don't. They think there's such a thing as process. There's no such thing as process, actually. We're just insisting on dreaming that there's process. But really, every single moment of our dreaming is completely free. Our creativity is still completely free, even though we say we're dreaming that our creativity is bound by time, space, process, and form. It's not bound. So this instant, we're dreaming of cancer to cast doubt upon our freedom, right? But this dream of cancer, right, this minute, instant, is our creativity that's dreaming this is completely free. So we can dream anything else. We can dream of a perfectly healthy body this instant. That's all there is to it. Another Apex Yoga, simple clarity. That's all there is to it. That's all there is to it. Nothing more than that. No process involved at all. There never is any process involved in our livingness at all. But we're pretending that there is. But that pretense, again, has no effect on the freedom of our creativity. It does not limit it in the slightest bit. Not in the slightest bit. So, you know, let us all realize that we might get a text from our friend, good friend, like this. And we're faced with this. And we must adhere to Apex Yoga, even in the face of this. I know it seems difficult, but there's no such thing as a death sentence. Okay? There's no such thing as a death sentence. And therefore, there's no such thing as death. Okay? There really isn't any such thing as death. It's just, again, just an appearance in the moment, like every other appearance in a dream. It's just dreaming, but at every moment, our creativity is perfectly, vividly alive and present. So that never dies at all. So we have a dream death, but there was no real death take place at all. There's no limitation of our creativity ever taking place. The freedom of our creativity. Never is it limited. So God is this perfect attribute freeness, so to speak, you might say, that never takes on the taste of anything that we're experiencing, because all potential is inherently there. Something like perfectly reflective. There's nothing it can't reflect perfectly. There's nothing that God cannot reflect perfectly. It's like a mirror. The mirror is never changed by what appears in front of the mirror. And so, whatever we want to have appear in the mirror, whatever it is always vividly apparent. And yet, we're perfectly free to change in some other appearance, and that appearance is not affected at all by what appeared previously in the mirror. I mean, imagine if there was a mirror that you made a funny face in front of the mirror, and then you went to the side of the mirror, and then you came back, and you looked in the mirror, and you still saw a funny face, because somehow an imprint of the funny face was on the mirror, and you say, "Well, I can't see. I have a happy face. I can't see that because the mirror still has this impression of a funny face. Some process has taken place." Well, that never happens with God. Never happens with God. There's never any impression of process, dynamic, form, anything, any impression upon the mirror, perfect reflective mirror of God. So, however we want to experience, it's always vividly clear and apparent, exactly as we asked for. And even if we stay in front of this mirror with a certain face for almost endless moments, still, if we want to shift to some other expression, there's not the slightest impression upon God, even if we spend trillions and trillions and trillions and trillions on moments exactly the same. When we decide to have a different experiencing, it's untouched by all those other moments. The reflection is still absolutely pure. So God is this perfect, untouchable purity. That's the ground of our being. That's the ground of life. That's the basis of our livingness, which is the flow of creativity. I'll do a random, what song is going to be on here? Nothing. What is this? Mode. Let me try this again. There you go. I'm just going to go do, 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 do. Didn't work. Okay. The intricacies of. Now that worked. I have a CD player. Actually, I have a CD player. I had to buy this used. You can't get one like this really anymore. It's really a good one. All you can get is this super cheap junk from China. And turn it up all the way. I gotta dance right on the spot. Yeah. Man, it's so cool to hear just something that sounds so certain in the age of this fast uncertainty, isn't it? Simple stuff. I love to dance right on the spot. Yeah. Just love to dance right here on the spot, which is kind of what we're doing. We're just dancing right here on the spot, right on the moment here. We just decide to dance. Apex Yoga just dances right on the spot. Really, it does. I feel that way most of the time, is I just feel like dancing right on this moment, right on the spot. But then I get all nervous because people say, "Oh, scary! What was that? What's wrong with him?" That's the problem with this world, crazy place, isn't it? You never just see that anymore. You used to see it in the '60s, but it was mostly drug fueled. But it was so tolerated because so many people were on drugs that you could get away with that a little bit. And those who react to it, those were the squares, and we'd be like, yeah, all right. Somebody's just dancing right on the spot. But, do you see that anymore? No way. Do you see anybody's just in the groove, just flowing in the groove? No, we're all wondering. Doubting our groove, aren't we? We're doubting our groove. We're doubting our purity. We're doubting the purity of our experiencing. We're doubting the purity of our experiencing. That's the game that's going on. I love to dance, yeah. So maybe I'll be dancing, but the knee gets better. I can, you know, I'm might have, you know, too much workout. I don't know. Yeah, I'm pretty sore. I'm really hitting it super hard now. Why not? Well, you guess you can overdo it a little bit. I gotta chill out about the weather and about everything. I've really been noticing I've been backsliding in a lot of ways. Subtle little things. I said, hey, I haven't done that in a long time. Hey, I notice my attention is getting pulled back towards the world. I noticed that. Well, you have to expect that will happen, because if the world is really, you know, up in its game, isn't it? Yeah, it is. So we have to up our game. You know, it's time for us to up our game. It really is. I have to up my game. So I'm praying to Longchenpa and Padmasambhava and the Dharma Kings, you know, for the grace to up my game. I've got to up my game at this point. The world is striking back and in a nasty way, as expected. So, you know, we're making these adjustments as we go along. We realize we reach a point where we realize, okay, we got to up our game, because, yeah, things are getting even worse, and they most certainly are, as expected. So that's the remedy. That's the remedy. I thought my game was, you know, really great, but here comes the world, you know, punching back. So, oh my gosh, all right. Just have to accept it. We have to up our game. I asked Longchenpa today what needs to be done. Silent intensive. By silent intensive, we mean be committed to no action. Be committed to no action. We're just sitting here, committed to no action. And I said, for how long? And 3 hours. So I'm supposed to do these 3-hour intensives. 3-hour mini intensives. Committed to no action. Silent as far as, what's our action, really? What are we doing to fix the world? Nothing. Nothing. There is no world to fix. That is a fact. The more we try to fix the world, the worse our situation becomes, actually. Because that just reinforces that there is a world to fix, which means we've changed what we are. We believe we've changed what we are. We're doubting, severely doubting, we are what we truly are, which is free in the perfect purity of God, the everlasting, eternal purity of God that is never colored in any way by any experiencing we have. It's never tinted. It's always pristine, always immaculate. I told my friend, I said, just let your wisdom soar. You're in the driver's seat now, because you have nothing to lose. You have nothing to lose, so you're in the driver's seat now. Let your wisdom soar. It's true. He's got nothing to lose. So now is his time. His time. You know, 2 to 6 months to live. Death sentence proclaimed upon him. Hey, I got nothing to lose. I'll just let my wisdom, let it soar like an eagle. I want to soar like an eagle, though I may wander far away from home. I know I'll never walk alone, fly like a bird. I want to soar like an eagle. Let our wisdom soar. Let our wisdom soar. We're outside here, kind of late at night, 9 o'clock. The storm is approaching. The weather system's approaching. It's going to go boom, 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 boom. They're expecting it in some locales by the end of 10 to 20 inches, I guess, in some mountain ranges of California. Not good for the Oroville Dam. Not good for the roads around here. Yeah, this is just a super wet winter, which is exactly what we needed. So we're thrilled, but we should have planned for this ahead of time, and fixed the dams during. The time to fix dams is when there's a drought, folks. And the knuckleheads didn't do that because the all-seeing meteorologist said, This drought could last for 100 years, there's no hurry. It's just really a really prolonged drought. Oh, guess what? One of the wettest winters in history is happening now, and all the reservoirs are full, and they're about ready to overflow. And the spillways aren't working, and they're eroding, and, it just goes on and on. Good Lord, Sign of the times, huh? Very, very, very unwise leaders have been in place for quite some time now. All they can think about, is this frothy stuff. It's just all froth. I was driving along today in the Bay Area. You see all these trucks, and I saw today many new trucks, delivery trucks. I said, "What is that? What is that?" Green goodness, green lunch. They deliver a lunch to you, or I think your children, they could go to school, and there's like this green organic lunch delivered to you. And then the next one is some kind of organic tea or something, some serendipity thing, tea, where it's this like truck that like delivers this like organic tea to you wherever you are. And there's just all these .com trucks now all over the place. Most of them have to do with food. And it's like they're obsessed with food. And the idea we can just, get on the smartphone or the app, dial for food arrives at our door. They think, I'm the queen and king of indulgence here. How smart, how brilliant we are. So it goes on and on now. Vans and trucks everywhere with .com, organic. It's got to be organic, just. And they're driving around, delivering stuff to people. Like that. It's just amazing. It's like mushrooms are popping up like mushrooms now. Same thing with the .com thing. Same thing happened. So that's why I say a bust is coming. A venture capitalist, a friend of mine knows, a really well-placed venture capitalist, and the venture capitalist says the same signs are here now before the .com bust. Same signs. It's just kind of a euphoria, like the money will never end. And so we could all just have the world delivered to our door like this. And, just everybody's just rolling in money. Okay. But we don't need that, do we? We don't need that. What we have is we have apexyoga.com delivered to our door, right? The very simple insights, and certainty delivered right to our computer here. It's even free. How cool is that? Doesn't get any cooler than that. Now I looked up how to increase your golf swing speed to hit it farther. That's a little thing I've been capitalizing on for lack of anything else to do. I said, well, I can't play golf, so I might as well work out so I can increase my swing speed. And the speed you turn your hips is really important. It's like the fulcrum. And it was pointed out to me why this is important, and I understand it. It's true. So there's some exercise. I tried some exercises now to like just get the hips like be able to just rotate really fast, strong and fast, whoo, like that, whoo, just real fast. So that's a little fun thing to do. You just have to keep on. Improving. Keep on improving your clarity of distinctions. So you just see the clear choice. And the clear choice is that there is no choice. Truth is true, nothing else is true. There's not. You can't choose untruth because it's not there. You can't choose lack of freedom because it doesn't exist. You can't choose to see that either pure God or impure God. There's no such thing. There's only pure. God's totally pure, uncorruptible. So there is no choice to make, actually. But the choice we make is to delay the inevitable, which is to see that there's no choice. We don't have a choice in our situation. We don't have a choice. We're perfect. Everything's perfect. Reality's perfect. We'll always be that way. We'll always reflect what we want to experience perfectly. And we think this world is an impure reflection, so God would never reflect such a thing. You know? No, God doesn't choose what we have to experience or what shows up in the mirror. I mean, we're free to imagine that the mirror is blurry or something. You know, it's not reflecting properly. No, it's reflecting perfectly. We're just using our creativity in a very odd way. That's for sure. But we're free to do so. And our creativity is totally free. In other words, any instant we could have a different experiencing. There's nothing standing in the way of that. There's nothing standing in the way of this entire universe disappearing or changing into something else this instant, actually. Nothing standing in the way of that. Never will be. So that might scare us, but being scared about it doesn't change the fact at all. So we have to up our game now. So I got home and I said, man, I feel tired. My muscles, I'm working out. I did like, I don't know, 60 push-ups again today. It's like, okay, what do I do? Well, I got this chocolate protein drink, Odwalla chocolate protein drink, 32 grams of protein. Then I put in 2 big scoops of chocolate protein powder, whey protein powder. Then I threw in a whole bunch of organic, a whole bunch of fresh blueberries. Yeah, I don't know, 50 or more. And that's it. So I've been drinking that. That's my dinner. Got to get the recovery from all the massive workouts I've been doing. Because you could feel really weak and tired after doing that, actually. You feel worse for a while. But it's a price you pay. But recovery is important. Same thing with a spiritual workout. You may feel worse, dumber after it for a while. That's the wow, shock. You feel dumber. But if you just push through that, full stop on the wow, later on, you'll feel wow. You realize several days later, really, really, really clear. Even clearer than you've ever been before. This has always been the way for me. I can testify to this. It's exactly what happens. Getting stronger and stronger and stronger. Clearer and clearer and clearer and clearer and clearer. Recognizing the sunyata, the emptiness of the ground of being of God. The perfect emptiness. The perfect purity of it. Lacking any specific attribute in itself. Being able then to perfectly reflect all attributes, clearly, right? But then I just said, okay, that's good. That's nice progress. But I know, okay, more is coming, so just don't fixate on it. And maybe that's why I'm feeling pretty blah. It was so shocking. It's just like, oh my gosh, I've gotten to the quote-unquote emptiness thing. All right, just kind of stumbled upon it. Just that's where my mind's able to just look at it and say, oh yeah, okay, that's what it, you know, emptiness. Okay, yeah, I see it. But there's no particular feeling like I've got to grasp it or this is it or something. It's just okay. That's where I am. That's fine. And what's going to arise next? You know. Like that. But it is pretty shocking. I get me, you know, I feel like nervous because, like, oh my gosh, you know, emptiness. Like, oh, so I just have to calm down from that. When you get these really big milestones, it can shake you up because you start worrying about your expectations. Like, I'm not sure what to expect now. Right, Buddha mind or something, right? Well, yeah, that's what should be, you know. But I don't try to expect anything. I expect wow to happen. That's it. Expect wow to happen. Now, when the smoothie gets down like this, what I do is I pour water in it and dilute it. So I'm going to dilute this, and then that, of course, stretches it out. Stretches it out. Plus, you get more hydration. So I'm just going to pour water in here. All right, that dilutes it quite a bit. So now it's twice as much, but it's diluted. Tastes great. It was a little too thick, thick before. So with this, wow, it's fabulous. I must admit, I was feeling so lousy when I came home. There's this half bag of cheese puffs. What do you call them? Cheez-Its or something like that. I ate them all. I said, ah. And then and I was too tired to go in and do something good for myself, you know, like make this smoothie. I was so wiped out. And then there was a bag of Doritos, and I opened those up, small bag. I ate the whole bag of Doritos. And then I tried to sleep for a while. I had to take two naps today. I feel so lousy. I really feel just my nerves are just shot. And then finally I said, no, come on. You know, take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. So get back on the horse and build up your strength. Keep training. Keep training. Keep training. But it seems like every day, shocking news arrives. I mean, a couple of weeks ago, someone else, you know, relative, terrible cancer. It's ridiculous. So the good news has to, you know, outpace the bad news, and it does. It does. So what is the great good news? We need it. We need it to arise right now. We need it to arise. Well, I got the Beach Boys on here. That's pretty good news. Let me see what the next song is. She wears away the sunlight. Good Vibrations. Oh, Good Vibrations is the song. Yeah. Wow. I mean, just how cool is that? Good Vibrations. Just listen to it if you're on YouTube. I'm picking up good vibrations. I mean, what was this? Good, was this 1966, baby? Or Good Vibration? I mean, there's n is there something that has like surpassed this song? Good Vibrations, man. Yeah. Couple days ago, my voice was really good, and here comes another cold to ruin it. I said, ah, that's what backlash. I must have gotten scared. You know, success is what scares us. I say, oh, no. I don't want to sing. You know, scary. Yeah. The world is such an uptight place right now. Such a hysterical place. The thing about the 60s that was so great was that everyone was invited to the party, and the older people were invited, so they could let their hair down, and you know. But these days, no.
Gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with the hoop. Gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with the hoop. Gotta keep those loving good. Ooh, good vibrations.
So we were all grooving to good vibrations back then. But about midway through 1969, the vibration, the good vibrations stopped, and they haven't come back. They really haven't. That means the good vibrations were never really there. Because Jesus says, what doesn't have value right now never had value. And what does have value right now always has had value. Okay, so you never lose value. Time and good time and good, good timing, yeah. Wow, it takes good timing. Well, valuing is always here. So it always has good timing. It always has good timing. We can't not have good timing. Ooh, ooh, all about good, good timing, yeah. Ooh, 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 good, good timing, yeah. We're all going places and sharing each other's wisdom, right? A celebration of being together. Ooh, about good, good timing. Ooh. What a groove. You know, what a groove. What a groove. Where did our groove go? Where did our groove go? It didn't go anywhere. It's still here. But we were imagining because our belief in time, space, process, and form, we imagine it has to change. And if you hold on to your group, people say, oh, there's something wrong with you. You're deviant. You're deviating from reality, as if reality is this must-change dynamic of relentless process in time, space, and form. And there's no truth to that at all. You never have to lose your groove. But the world says, well, we're leaving you. You're being left. You're being isolated. You're trying to separate ourselves. No. Those who believe in time, space, process, and form are trying to separate themselves from reality. So we're always grooved. There's only the groove. We're always in the groove. Do we have to ceaselessly keep shifting and changing? No, we don't. No, we don't. And we can always go back to whatever the groove that we've had before, and experience it again, fresh and clean and pure, as if reality is perpetually fresh. So when I hear these songs, for me, it's like I'm hearing them for the first time. The groove is still here with me. I feel the same kind of, oh, I'm just entering into this groove as I did 50 years ago. This is true. This is true. And I soar on the wings of that groove, just as I did then. For me, there's no difference. It's still fresh. It's just fresh and fresh and fresh again. Like that.
Okay. There you go. Gotta get it right here. The fourth one. Okay, boom. It's the fourth button. Good timing. Hey, it went back to good timing again. It's boom. It's random.
Round, get around. I get around. Yeah,
get around.
Woo, I get around.
Yeah.
Now, I've heard this song thousands of times, but every time I hear it, it's like I'm kind of renewed. The groove is renewed. Yeah, the bad guys know us and they leave us alone. Get around, round, get around. Ah, it's always this groove. Nobody grooved it like the Beach Boys, right? And the groove is still there. And this is what's so amazing. That's why I'm bringing this up here in Apex Yoga. We can't lose our groove. So we're perpetually young. We're perpetually fresh. We're perpetually fresh. I get around, round, get around. I get around town to town. I'm a real cool head. I'm making real good bread. I get around, round. Woo! Round, round, get around. I get around, yeah, get around. Woo! I get around, round, round, get around. It just groove out, you know, just the intro and outro. This outro is just fabulous. The Beach Boys are great with that. They like swing you into the groove with the intro. What's the next one going to be? I don't know. But they understood that you want to just get glide in and get swept into this intro, and then you hit your groove, and then get swept out into the next groove like that. Get you back.
Woo, ha, ooh, 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 yeah.
So you get, this is just like, you get sort of just soared, like you're soaring into this groove.
We got some very, very continuity fear-ridden people in the world right now, mind, spirits. The world is full of spirits that are bedeviled by severe continuity fear, which means they believe in concretization. And so all they can do is all this froth, the dot-com frothness, tech frothness. They can't really hit their groove, okay? They can't. They can't dispense with concretization. They just have to have more of it. The Bay Area is all this froth. It's the center of froth. So much froth. Dot-com froth. But underneath that is this very hardened belief in concretization. Extremely big, hardened belief in concretization. The time, space, process, form are real. So they're trying to cover that up with all this froth. Frothy stuff. There's no substance to any of this stuff here. There's no groove to it.
Woo, can I ever get you back? always, of course, I could always get you back. I could always get the groove back. I could always get you back. I could always get the groove back, of course. There's no groove that we can't get back instantly, this instant. Great outro here. Again, another great outro. You just kind of like, just feel like you're just dancing and dissolving into beingness, isness, as you do this outro like this. And then you're like, oh, okay, it's all perfect, it's all good. That's how to listen to music, isn't it? What's the next song? I don't know. Random Shuffle. I love this. It's got Random Shuffle. CD with it. Ooh, ooh, this is the way I always dreamed it would be, the way that it is, oh, when you are holding me. I never had love of my own, maybe that's why when we're all alone, I can hear music. I can hear music. Sound of the city, baby, seem to disappear. Whoa, and I can hear music. Sweet, sweet music. Whenever you catch me, baby, whenever you're near. Oh, loving you, oh, it keeps me satisfied, and I can't explain, no, the way I'm feeling inside. You look at me, we kiss, and then I close my eyes, and here it comes again. I can hear music. I can hear music. One of the greatest grooves ever, this song. The sounds of the city, baby, seem to disappear, man. That's right. Because whenever we hit the groove of nowness, that music of isness, the sound of the world disappears. The sound of the world, that feeling of the world. The belief in the world is just a feeling we have. It's a lack of the groove. When we lack the groove, there seems to be a world. And we're taught, you got to feel that this world, you got to feel there's a world here. Ooh, let the music hold me tight. Music, music, baby. Ooh, I can hear music. I can hear music. The sounds of the city, baby, seem to disappear. Oh, and I can hear music, sweet, sweet music, just like that. We should always hear the sweet, sweet music of the groove. We're never out of the groove, but we're pretending that there is no more groove. Da 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 da. What's this? What's the intro? Fun, fun, fun. Another groove. Yeah, she's got her daddy's car and she cruised to the hamburger stand now. Ooh, got all about the library like she told her old man now. Whoa, rip the radio blast and goes cruising just as fast as she can now. And she'll have fun, 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 to the daddy takes the tear away. Ooh, whoa, 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 yeah, yeah. Next time in ace now, you walk like an ace now. Man, what a groove this one is. Look like an ace now, you look like an ace. And she'll have fun, 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 now that daddy takes the tea root away. Boop, doo doop, doo doop, doo 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 doop. You knew all along that your dad was getting wise to you now. And since he took your set of keys, you've been thinking that your fun is all through now. But you can come along with me, cause we got a lot of things to do now. And we'll have fun till the daddy took the T-root away. Oh yeah. We'll have fun now that daddy took the T-root away. T-root away. There's the outro again. Woo! Okay, come down. There you go. Da 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 da. Wah. This beautiful outro just smooths it out like that. Holy cow. Surfing now, everybody's learning how. Come on and safari with me. Do. Early in the morning, we'll be starting out. Some honeys will be coming along. Woo-hoo. Loading up our woody with the boards inside and headed out singing our song. Woo-hoo-boop. Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Whoop, 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 whoop. Bop, ba-da-ba-da-bop, bop, ba-da-ba. Come and get ready to go. Woo, bop. I'm gonna take you surfing with me. Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Wop, 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 wop. Like that. So, another beautiful groove. Way to the shores of Peru. Woo-hoo. Come on, babe, now. Surfing safari, yeah. I'm gonna take you surfing safari. Come on a long surf trip, yeah. Surfing safari, yeah. I'm gonna take you surfing safari. Now. Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on in safari with me. Coming on, baby. Safari with me. Safari with me, yeah. Safari with me. Safari with me. Yeah, let's go to J Bay, man, in South Africa, or Skeleton Bay in Namibia, or this new place that Nick Fanning has discovered. Nobody knows where it is. Mozambique, they say. Woohoo, the perfect right. Dig the same things that turned me on as a kid. Woohoo, when I grew up to be a man. Say that I wish I hadn't done what I did. Woohoo, would I grow up to be a man? Now I'm young and free, but how will it be when I grow up to be a man? Woo, woo, ah, do 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 do. Will I love my wife for the rest of my life, rest of my life? When I grow up to be a man, what will I be? Be a man. A deep.
won't last forever. Feels kind of sad. Won't last forever. Feels kind of sad. Yeah, won't last forever. Well, the groove can last forever. It does last forever. It's here right now. Apex Yoga dials you into this fact. The ultimate intro. Don't worry, baby. It can last forever. It always lasts forever. Everything lasts forever. Everything lasts forever. So everything is perpetually grooved. There's no such thing as not grooved. When she says, don't worry, baby, everything will turn out all right. Don't worry, baby. Woo, there's some notes I can't hit when I'm doing it sotto voce. That voice cracks, it's bound to.
Come alive and makes me wanna drive when she says, don't worry, baby. Everything will turn out all right. Don't worry, baby. This that in the musical instrumental is so cool. All this just organ going doot. When she says, don't worry, baby.
Wow. One of the greatest songs ever. One of the greatest grooves ever.
Don't worry, baby. Thing will turn out all right.
Everything's grooved forever. Everything's always grooved. There's no such thing as a moment that's not perfectly grooved. Okay, Apex Yoga. There's no such thing as a moment that's not perfectly grooved. Darling. Darling would say, woo. I fight away. What you mean to me? It was meant to be. I hold you in my arms as life's most precious charms. Whoa, darling. You know, it's interesting that my friend, we were walking back from the funeral of his brother. His older brother just passed away in November. We're walking back from the church, and we're walking across a crosswalk, and he was expounding on something as he does, and he's just in the groove. He was in the groove, as he always is, and almost always is, and he's not in the groove right now. He's in the cancer groove. Well, he's in the groove. He's in the cancer groove. Okay. But, and I, something intuition said, hey, I was looking for traffic for some reason. I saw this truck coming. We're walking across a crosswalk. I saw this truck coming from the right down the street. I said, okay, he's going kind of fast. But then I realized, hey, wait a minute, he's not slowing down. There's like 10 people walking across a crosswalk. He's not slowing down at all. And then I said, whoa, wait a second. And then I realized he's not going to slow down. And my friend is walking with his head down, not paying any attention because he just came back from his brother's funeral. And I yell, hey, at him, and he
you know, stop him. And he stops, and he stops, and the car, the truck goes whoosh, right past. Now, he might have, he probably would have been killed if I hadn't yelled, hadn't have said something. But I said something, and he wasn't killed. Interesting. So today I told him, I texted him, I said, let your wisdom soar. You've got nothing to lose. You're in the driver's seat now, man. You're in the driver's seat right now. You are in the driver's seat, okay? People have written you off, so you're in the driver's seat, man. You got nothing to lose. Let your wisdom soar. You know, we all just sit petrified as people die, myself included, you know. It's pathetic. We're a bunch of pathetic wimps, you know, as unfortunately, and we have to get out of that. We need Pama Samba to do his Vajra dance. Pama Samba, do your Vajra dance for our friend, you know, for our dear friend, who's a voice of wisdom in the world, who always thinks outside the box. You know, everyone speaks conventional this, and he always says, you know, I see it differently, and then he's willing to express it in a crowd. You know, this is like the rarest of qualities. He's like the only person I know like that, actually. That even in the most desperate situations, came to visit us in the hospital, and everyone was saying, oh my God, this is horrible. He says, you know what? This is just meant to be. It's a reason, a purpose, and everything good's going to come of it. Don't worry. Don't panic, everybody. And he just calms. He's someone who can calm an entire room down from panic. You know, that's how awesome he is. And so we're going to bring in the lotus-born one, the never-born one, born perfectly enlightened one, realizing there is no birth, there is no world. Pama Samava, we ask you to visit our friend right now and do your Vajra dance, okay? Dance and dance a new groove into him, okay? Dance a new groove into him. And while you're at it, dance a new groove into us too. Okay? And then dance a new groove into everyone. Pama Samava, the great Vajra dancer. Vajra, the diamond-hearted dancer, the lotus-born one, who just appeared in the world as fully enlightened, and then disappeared as fully enlightened. But he says, I'm on the threshold of all my devotees. I'm on your threshold. Don't worry. I'm right there, right there, right now. I'm right here, right now for you. So we call upon you. And all the Dakinis and all the Bodhisattvas and all those who are bound by oaths to you, the whole contingent that is Padmasambhava, which is an awesome array. We ask this awesome array to dance a new groove for our friend who deserves it. He richly deserves it. He's richly deserving of it. You know, the world has said, hey, you need to have a cancer groove. Because maybe you're a cancer among us because you think outside the box. We don't want that kind of thinking anymore in this world. Well, Padmasambhava wants that kind of thinking in this world, wants that kind of that groove in the world. Okay, I want it. Okay, so there's two right there. Longchenpa wants it. You want it. Okay, so therefore, we have a decision. We want it. And Padmasambhava's boat carries so much weight. It's a done deal. Let's get a new dance going for the new groove going for our friend. Okay? And let's... new song. What is this new song? Ooh. Ooh. Little surfer, little one, makes my heart come all undone. Do you love me? Do you, surfer? Little surfer girl. Ooh, yeah. Now there's a groove. The first ballad that Brian Wilson ever wrote. It still strikes like lightning. The groove, it just sweeps you up irresistibly. Do you love me? Do you, surfer girl. Together, our half would grow. Everywhere I go. Do you love me? Do you surfer girl, my little surfer girl, little just sweeps you up. It still sweeps you up the same way the first time I heard it. It still sweeps me up. Ah. That's good vibrations again. Yeah. It just, the surfer girl just sweeps me up. As soon as I heard dun, first, dun, 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 and immediately I'm gone, do, 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 do. Immediately I'm just like, the groove suddenly just returns just like that. Right in the groove again. Even though I've heard it thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of times, you could tell. It's like the first time. I said, oh my God, what a great song. I can't believe what this song's blowing my mind. I just love this, the tempo and the groove and the smoothness and the soulfulness. And it's just, you know, what a groove. I mean, you know, folks, we talk about classical music and Bach. Okay, Bach, how long? 500 years. Bach's been around for a long time, right? And Bach's got a great groove, okay? It's very tech. Sort of electronic tech music, you know, like that. I don't really, I'm not into that type of groove, but it's a groove, okay, that's fine. So some people hear that right now, you know, it's just like, poof, immediately, they're in that groove again, it's like for the first time. And it's been around 500 years or so. Well, the Beach Boys, for me, 500 years from now, I hear Surfer Girl. I mean, it's like the first time. I mean, I am instantly in that groove again. This music is like Bach. You know, it's going to stand the test of time 1,000 years from now. Yeah, whatever. It's timeless music. It is timeless music, the Beach Boys. For me, it's what more can you say? It's timeless music. Surfer Girl is a timeless song. Yeah, it never gets old. It never gets old. And God knows, I've probably listened to the Beach Boys songs more than just about anybody. It just, because it always, I always have the same reaction. I just, oh my gosh, here we go. I just got to get into this groove. And, you know, there's other stuff that grooves too. Some of the disco music, you know, listening to it, retrospect, it's pretty good stuff too. They hit a pretty good groove there. Really, they did for dancing. You make me feel like dancing, yeah. Gonna dance the night away. Dancing, dancing, gonna dance the night away. You know, just, I mean, they just don't, I mean, they had a nice bouncy groove that you just can't help but, I'm at a store, I just can't help but start dancing. I'm the only one dancing. It's ridiculous. I mean, grocery shopping, and there's all this disco music going on. It's just, you make me feel like dancing. And I start dancing. Why not? Is that going to cause an earthquake or something? Maybe we think, yeah, everybody's going to be petrified, you know. Sometimes people smile at me and say, yeah, I feel like dancing too or something. But other people are like, and it's just, I'm just grooving just a little bit. You know, just make me feel like dancing. Just a little bit, you know, just like feel like, Can't we allow ourselves to realize we never lost the groove? We're perpetually groovy. That's the buzzword in the 60s, groovy. because we were feeling the groove. We said, we're never going to lose the groove. I mean, we grew up, that was it. We're going to stay in the groove. But we didn't. I tried, but everybody freaked out. Says, you got to grow up. You've got to evolve. Evolve, there's no evolution in God. Everything's perpetually free. There's no evolution in God at all. There never has been. There's just different grooves we can hit. That's all. And we can, whatever groove we hit now, we can always hit. And whatever groove we hit next, we can always hit. And on and on and on and on through eternity. There's only eternity. And again, yeah. So what's the next song? Beach Boys, play us a song. Would it be nice? Wouldn't it be nice if we were older? Then we wouldn't have to wait so long. And wouldn't it be nice together? Do 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 do. I'm not being concerned much better. Ooh, ooh, ah, be nice. Wouldn't it be nice? Yeah. Ba 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 da 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 da. We're perpetually grooved. We're perpetually tubed. I was watching this, I've been watching these surf videos. There's this new surf spot with that Mick Fanning, the Australian three-time world champion from Australia, discovered with Rip Curl. Rip Curl goes on these explorations to find new surf spots and then publicizes them and they're ruined. Because everybody finds out about them. And the few that know about these secret spots, that they ruin it. And so some people don't like that. But anyway, in today's age, people think that there's no more great waves to be discovered in the world. They've all been discovered. Because with Google Maps and smartphones, people are all over the world are looking for secret surf spots right now. It's a big thing. Well, Rip Curl went with Mick Fanning, and they found this right point break that breaks like just 20 meters from the shore. It's so close to the shore, and it's just like this perpetual tube, right? Tube, this barrel. And it just goes and goes and goes and goes and goes and goes. And it's astonishing. It's like a perfect wave. It's like a wave garden wave. Like a Kelly Slater wave garden wave. But it's real. And they showed video of him just a couple days ago. It's really hit the internet. It's just like people are saying, where is that? Because they wouldn't tell where it is. It's a secret. People say it's Mozambique. They think it's got to be Mozambique. There's some real sharpies out there. The color of the water, the swell direction, this time of year. They traced it. You know what kind of. I mean, they're sharp, and they say it's got to be on the coastline of Mozambique somewhere, but very hard to find because the coastline of Mozambique is massive with all these deltas. It's pretty much unexplored by surfers. And that was just amazing. And then someone was saying, well, it's a right-hand skeleton bay. I said, what's Skeleton Bay? So I looked that up. And Skeleton Bay is in Namibia, in a desolate, desolate place in Namibia. And it's a left-hand point break. And it's gnarly. And it's just insane. And people discovered that like back in 2008 or something, at a contest, who could find the best new surf spot. And someone found this spot. And it's so desolate. It's like a 36-mile-hour trip from South Africa to get there by car. There's a lot of sharks there. It's super heavy, gnarly wave, breaks so many boards. And it's a screamer. It's a perpetual screaming left. Oh, so I was watching that. I could hardly believe it. And you talk about being in a groove, perpetually barreled. That's like us, but that's what we are. Spirit is always in, always barreled, perfectly barreled, perfectly. We're always in the barrel. Na 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 na. Heroes and villains, listening to. I don't know what the next groove is going to be. Little do scoop, you don't know what I got. Little do scoop, you don't know what I got. No, I'm not brave. I got it. If I sing Mike Love, like, I got to sing it loud. Otherwise, it doesn't sound right. When someone comes up to me, he don't even try. Because if he had a set of wings, man, I know she could fly. She's my little do scoop. You don't know what I got. Got to sing it louder than that. It's very nasally strong sound. You can't do it quietly. Like she's standing still. She's ported and relieved, and she's stroked and bored. She'll do 140 in the top end floor. She's my little dude scoop. Whoa, you don't know what I got. Don't know what I got. Competition clock. Do, 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 do. Woo, leg pops up. Woo, flip your lid. One more thing, I got the big slip, daddy. Coming off the line when the light turns green. Woo, do, do scoop, do scoop. She's my little do scoop. You don't know what I got. You don't know what I got. Little do scoop. You don't know what I got. Yeah, you don't know what I got. Jeez, man. Wow, the wind is cranking right now. Like the wind is in a groove. Be true to your school. Be true to your school. Be true to your school. That last song got me tired because I couldn't hit the right key. So I forced it, and it wasn't flowing properly. And then I switched over to harmony, and it was better. If you can't get a groove with the lead voice, switch to harmony, and then you can find a groove. Always find a groove with harmony. Always find a groove with harmony. Let Pamasamva Vajrasattva do his Pamasamva dance. Let Vajrasattva do his Pamasamva dance. Apex yoga here. Apex 217 intensive. Apex. First Apex yoga 217 intensive video here where we introduce some singing, kind of. Which is cool because I've been wanting to do this for a long time. And for some reason, I felt like I had nothing to lose. You know, my friend's cancer, I just said, you know what? Let me be in solidarity with him. I got nothing to lose. Let's just go for it, okay? And for some reason, it was so easy to do. I just couldn't do it before. I couldn't do it. I don't know why. It wasn't the right timing. There's a time, right? And this is the time. Because the first Apex Yoga Intensive, I guess I was waiting to say, okay. I decided that, okay, I'm going to do Apex Yoga. I'm going to be an Apex Yogin on February 13th. Today's the 15th. So I decided that during the day, and I said, I committed to Longchamp. Okay, Longchamp, I'll do it. I'll do the one-year Apex Yoga Intensive. I'm now an Apex Yogin. You got it. You're the man. You're the adept, supreme adept. Okay, let's do it. And then later on in the evening time, I came across this saying, this we're posting this on the anniversary of Longchamp. They're posting some poem that he did. And I say, what do you mean anniversary of Longchamp? And I said, what is this, his birthday? I started Googling it and said, people say, well, it's February 1st, it's February 3rd. There's a lot of different dates, but sort of more than any other, it's February 13th. And so I said, oh my gosh, I didn't know this. I didn't know what his birthday was. So on the very day of his birthday, I commit to do the Apex Yoga Intensive and be an Apex Yogin, which is a pretty cool birthday present for Longchenpa. I imagine that's got to rank up there with really heart-touching birthday presents. That someone was 600 years or so, 600 plus, 648 years, I think it's been. Is that 458, 6, could be 648 years since the body appearance dissolved here in this world. in some place in halfway around the world, another culture and continent that's completely different than his the one that he was in, someone commits to do a apex yoga intensive under him and says, okay, I'm now an apex yoga longchampa. I will do it. I mean, that has got to, I don't know how he feels about it, but, you know, I just probably feels great about it. I know how he couldn't feel great about it. He has to feel great about it, you know? I mean, he's not saying, ah, rats, you know, doggone it. maybe he's just like, yeah. So I try not to anticipate it because probably it's overwhelming. Probably he's just like doing cartwheels. I mean, he's just like thrilled. You know, he's just in some thrill groove of just like, this is just so totally great. So totally great. Someone has come along and said, okay, let's do it. Okay, you're the supreme adept of apex yoga, and I love apex yoga. And I'm in the groove of apex yoga, Longchampa, so let's sing that song. Let's sing that song together. I'll sing harmony. You sing lead, I'll sing harmony. I'll blend in with the lead occasionally, just like I would, you know, but you, next song. Dum 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 be doo be dum 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 be doo be dum 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 be doo be dum whoa 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 love 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 and come and go with me. And that's a nice doo wop kind of song. There's a world where I can go and share my secrets too in my room, in my room, in my room, in my room. Worries and my fears in my room, in my room, in my room. Yeah. Another great ballad. Lie awake and pray to my drying and my sighing last threat yesterday. Now it's dark and I'm alone and I won't be afraid in my room, 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 in my room. In my room. Great, another great outro, right? I mean, are you kidding me? It's just, I wanna dance and hold my hand. Tell me, baby, am I a loving man? Oh, baby, do you wanna dance? Do you wanna dance? Oh, yeah. We wanna just perpetually in the groove. We're perpetually in the groove. Just feel that we're in the groove. We're in the utmost groove of perpetual purity. 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 So sick to today and so tired, exhausted. But I said, you know what? I'm an apex yogin. And so we got to lay it on the line right here. And we got to kick things off. And I can't sit around waiting. My friend is got this raging lung cancer, okay? So it's time to up the ante right now. Look out, you know. Pama Samba is here now, dancing his dance, doing his groove. It's like Longchenpa's got this band, and he says, you don't like to bring out a guest right now. We got a special guest that's going to join us for this part of the concert. And like, y'all, put your hands together and welcome Pama Samava, the lotus-born one, Guru Rinpoche. Come on out. And out comes Guru Rinpoche. Yeah. And we all get to groove to groove for a while with Guru Rinpoche right now, right? We get to groove with Guru Rinpoche. How is that? How cool is that? It's part of one of that's one of Longchenpa's surprise guests. He's got a bunch of surprise guests. He, you know, Longchenpa's the supreme adept, so he can call anyone in. You can call anyone in. It's like the Beatles or something, you know. You know, we like to bring up Billy Joel. We like to bring up, you know, whoever. You know, come on the stage. They can just invite anybody, and who's going to turn them down, right? Or someone has got the pull is such a big pull that. We got to bring a special guest that we're introduced tonight. The one that came down here to have some fun with us. Everybody put your hands together for Paul McCartney. Here comes Sir Paul. Oh, yeah? Yeah. All right. How's everybody feeling tonight? You know, chirpy Paul. Jet. Oh, Jet, I knew the major was a lady. Suffragette. Jet, woo, 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 woo. Much later, want you to always love me. So Paul does think of, all right, thank you, Paul McCartney. That's a heck of a song, Jet. That's got a groove to it. Really great song. Paul McCartney and Wings. Paul knew how to hit a groove. He knew how to hit a groove, yeah. He got his groove on. Every moment's a groove. Every breath is a groove. We're completely grooved. Even cancer is a perfect groove. let Pama Samba groove with your cancer. Let him groove with the cancer. You don't have to groove with it. Let him groove with it. He'll groove with it for a while, okay? It's like Ananda Mai Ma grooving with people's cancer. She took cancer on herself. She grooved with the cancer and says, wow, this is great. I love grooving with cancer. It's all perfect. And then after a while, she says, okay, I'm going to switch to another groove. Boom! The cancer disappeared instantly, like that. I've told the story many times. It's worth repeating. She had metastasized cancer throughout her entire body, and there was tumors everywhere. Horrible tumors. And she had one of the top doctors in India treating her, well, looking after her. And he says, like, one of the worst cancer I've ever seen. This is just, like, horrible. And he said, you must be in the most incredible pain imaginable. I can't, I've never seen anything like this. And she said, what? No, there's no pain. I feel great. I feel perfect. I'm blessed. And then he snuck into her room at night with a syringe with morphine. He was going to give her morphine while she slept because he couldn't take it anymore. And she was like meditating, sitting upright in her room at the middle of the night, and suddenly this bright flash of light in the room occurred. And some subtle form seemed to depart her body and leapt over this wall and ran away by the Ganges River into the darkness. And he was so shaken up, he dashed back to his room, shaking and trembling the whole night, and he couldn't sleep. He was so shocked by what had happened. And finally he crept back there in the morning time, and she was giving darshan or something, and he looked around a corner and took a look at it. And she was like, he couldn't believe his eyes. She was like in perfect condition. Like there would never have been any cancer at all, not a trace of it. This was one of the top scientific doctors of India, okay? Head of the university, okay? This is big, something like that. He was a really super solid, reputable person. And he reported his cancer absolutely vanished, like it never was. Her health's perfect. As perfect as they could be, because her health went all over the place. You never do. She had no pulse 1 minute, and, you know, racing. She said, forget about my health. Don't worry about it, doctor. Doc, you know, it'll drive you crazy. Just forget about it, okay? It's whatever it is at each moment. Whatever the groove is, that's what my health is. Don't worry about it. It's all perfect. So, absolutely. She was done grooving with the cancer. She took cancer off of, what, the world, maybe, you know, or something, right? Because the cancer wanted, you know, we want to groove with cancer. And she says, well, I'll groove with it for you, okay? You want to, okay, let me groove with it for a while. And then cancer will say, oh, okay, you know, we had that interesting groove with cancer, you know, cancer groove, and we don't need to groove with it for a while. Maybe diminish kind of our interest in it for a while. Who knows what she did, but it was sure, for sure it was profound. Definitely profound. Well, East Coast girls are hip. I really dig those styles they wear. And the Northern girls, well, that's the way they talk. They knock y'all out when I'm down there. Yeah, the Midwest farm. California girls. There's another intro that's just, you know, timeless intro. No. Northern girls, well, it's the way they kiss. Keep their boyfriends warm at night. I wish they all could be Californian girls. I wish they all could be Californian girls. Like that. Ooh. I want to pass out for lack of oxygen. Ooh, ah, ooh, ah, ooh, ah, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. Do, 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 do. Get it, girls in the world. Do, I wish they all could be California girls. Wish they all could be California girls. And this great outro, you know, just insanely great outro. I mean, it's the best. I mean, for me, it's just the toppermost of the poppermost pop music in the genre of this, you know, pop music. It's just like, yeah. If everybody had an ocean across the USA, then everybody be surfing. Mike Love again. Fortnite. I see you wearing their baggies. A ratchet sandals too. Bushy, bushy blonde hairdo. Surfing USA. Boop, 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 boop. Hatton.
And down to anyway, everybody's gone surfing. Out of root. Woo. Up the summer. We're on safari to stay. Well, the teacher, we're surfing. Surfing USA. I can't breathe. I can't oxygenate when I'm having to be quiet. Run out of breath. Run out of breath. Over Mahoya, Ayamaya Bay. Everybody's gone surfing. Surfing USA. Yeah, getting a little chilly, but oh yeah, I'm probably gonna get a cold. I don't know, can't get a cold, can I? Pop a song. I was gonna do this Bajra Desi. But it's got surfing, surfing USA. Everybody's gone surfing, surfing USA. We should have never taken drugs, folks, right? Nobody should have ever taken drugs. We would have been so much different. The whole world so much different. We would have, well, I'd do it in my head. I'm in late at night, and in the morning I just lay in bed. Al Jardine on this, I think. Well, Rhonda, you caught me fine, and I know it wouldn't take much time for you to ooh out of my heart. Do 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 do. Help me, Rhonda. Help, help me, Rhonda. Ooh. Wah, 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 wah. Ooh, ooh. Wah, 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 wah. Ooh. Whoa, 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 whoa. Help me, Rhonda, yeah. Get her out of my heart. Do, 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 do. Ooh, ooh. Hello, Rhonda. Ooh. Hello, Rhonda. Ah, ooh, you gotta, Rhonda, help me get her out of my heart. Do 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 do. Help me, Rhonda. Help, help me, Rhonda. Ooh, na 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 na. Ooh, ba 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 ba. Help me, Rhonda, yeah. Get her out of my heart. I have a hard time singing like Al Jardine. He's got a different voice. But I could do it, but I gotta really belt it. Help me, Rhonda, yeah. I like that. Intro, outros, and a nice... Up, tack it up, buddy, gonna shut you down. Yeah, fuel-injected Stingray and a 413. Revving up our engines and it sounds real mean. Tack it up, tack it up. Buddy gonna shut you down. Ooh. Ooh.
that the count of one people to accelerate. Moon is light, the slicks are starting to spin, but the 413's really digging in. Gotta be cool now, power shift, here we go. Super stock Dodge is running out in low, but my fuel injector stingray's really starting to go. To get the traction, I'm riding the clutch. The pressure plate's burning, this machine's too much. Whoop, 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 whoop.
There's another song I got a belt. It's easier to do the ballads quietly.
Through the four hills, two quads drink. Now the 413's lead is starting to shrink. I'm a ram induction, but it's understood. I got a fuel-injected engine sitting under my hood. Got it off, shut it off, buddy, now shut you down. Woo, shut it off, shut it off, buddy, now I shut you down. Ooh, shut it off, buddy, now I shut you down. Do, do, do. Shut it off, buddy, now I shut you down. Do, 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 do.
Hey, hey, Windy, hey, you should listen to Windy. And unfortunately, I don't think it's on this compilation, Windy. I love that song, too. Oh, God, God only knows. Another fabulous intro and fabulous outro. You know, one of the greatest songs ever. God Only Knows by the Beach Boys. It's ridiculous. The Beach Boys are just groovy. They're groovy. They're groovy. Apex Yoga groovy.
Need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you.
This is Carl Wilson. You have to sing it kind of strong. I cannot sing.
If you should ever leave me, life would still go on, believe me. The world would show nothing to me. So what would we're living to me? God only knows.
This part, I have to sing strong. The voice drops out. I have a lot of fun with this song when I'm in driving and just really singing it strong. Can't do it. Missed.
Knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, would you still go on, believe me? The world would show nothing to me. So what good would living to me? God only knows what I'd be without you.
You see, he drops down out of the falsetto there. you have to hit that just right. The right voice of air pressure, vocal pressure, art drops out.
Woo.
That's Brian.
Woo.
Or maybe it's Carl, because I don't know if Brian sang on the song.
Woo. He knows, God only knows. God only knows. Woo.
No, I can't do it. It's a tough song to sing. You gotta really hit the right pitch and pressure, air pressure on this one. Carl's a little bit difficult to sing with. He's able to have that high voice. He's able to go back and forth between the high regular then low falsetto. That Sloop John B. Wow, see? Perpetually grooving here.
I didn't do a fight. Well, I feel so broke up. I wanna go home. Throw up the John B. sails. See how the mainsail sets.
Call for the captain ashore, let me go home. Let me go home. I wanna go home. Yeah, yeah. Well, I feel so broke up. I wanna go home. Do did it, do did it, do did it, do do boop boop. My voice starting to get tired. Losing the edge to it. Constable had to come and see it's flat. Babe. Sheriff Johnstone, why don't you leave me? Well, I feel so broke up. Ooh. It's endless summer. We never wanted the Beach Boys to end, but they tried to change their groove to compete with the Beatles. Don't do that. Why don't you let me go? Ooh, I feel so broke up. I wanna go. Can't do it right now. Lost the high voice. So this is so important to talk about this. I committed to be an apex yogin. So I'm not trying to compete with anything else. Okay? So I'm just going to stay in the groove that I have. I'm not going to try to compete with any other groove that's going on. All right? Oh, hoist up the John B. sails. See how the... Can't do it. Can't do it. Sail for the captain ashore, let me go home, let me go home. Usually I can sing this song, just bam, 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 just nail it, everything. But cold, the cold, I've got kind of tired, everything's just eh. Okay, that's fine. I got the eh groove right now. Ba, 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 boorang, oh, take my hand. There you go, more groove going on. Hoist up the John B. sail. This is the worst ship I've ever been on. Well, yeah, we need to hoist up the John B. sail right now. The apex yoga sail. I hope I said apex yoga before. Maybe I made a misspoke. But apex yoga. I got the apex yoga groove. The apex yoga groove. Wow. Got to remember, don't compete with some other groove. And this is the trouble I experienced when I was younger. I had a groove, but there's all these other spiritual teachers that are so big and wow, publishing all these books, and they're just huge. And it's like, I felt like, oh, I need to be like them, kind of. I kind of need to be like them. With no, you know, big mistake. I had the apex yoga groove when I was young, but the world had no idea what I was talking about, really. I said, who do you think you are, Ramaharshi or something? And I said, well, Apex Yogin. So, like the Beach Boys competed with the Beatles, I felt like, oh, I need to kind of like sound like this or fit in this way with this groove, you know, whatever it may have been. There's a lot of different grooves going on. Even a Krishnamurti groove or whatever, you know, right? So many different grooves. Instead of just being an apex yoga and staying with that groove. And so what I'm committing to now is to stay in the apex yoga groove for this year. Just stay in that groove. I'm not going to stray into some other groove unless it happens to be the right thing to do. Okay, so I'm not boxing myself in. I'm free. I'm still free. But I understand the importance. After 6 hours of school. Yeah. Dance, dancing again. I gotta dance. See, my voice is gone. Voice is gone. So,
Dance, yeah. Staying in the groove is an apex yoga is really, truly the super simple, super clear Something got caught in the spider web there. That's not good. I gotta get rid of that spider web because this. Here, let me. Double up when it's fast. I love the dance. That's enough of that spider web. I don't like to see, something get caught in that web. It's a big old flying insect, and there's a spider web that's been there for quite a few days. And I said, I gotta get rid of this spider web. I don't like the spider like hanging out. The light's on, it's attracting insects to it, you know, and that's so I'm responsible for the light there. So I can't have a spider hanging out there. You know, that's no good. That's no good. That's no good. So that's it. I kind of figured, what should I do? Well, that just triggered. I said, okay, that's enough. That's enough of that. That's enough of that foolishness. So it's like the world spins these webs that you come here, you groove into the light, and you get caught in this web. You think, oh, I need to groove this way. But there's not much apex yoga groove in this world, okay? The Dharma Kings have an apex yoga groove. They are the apex yoga groove, as a matter of fact. Like Ramaharshi is the apex yoga groove, right? He absolutely is. Beautiful apex yoga groove. There is no world. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing has ever happened. A Course in Miracles is actually an apex yoga groove. If you're really feeling it. Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take a tour, Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama, Largo, Montego, ooh, I wanna take a trip to Kokomo, we'll get there fast and then we'll take it slow, that's where we wanna go, down in Kokomo. A friend of mine's in Aruba right now. Someone else said, that's terrible, Aruba. It's 3 miles by 7 miles wide. You can see the whole island from just looking at the whole thing at once. It's like, it's like no trees higher than a couple of feet. It's wind, 60-mile-an-hour wind all the time. Terrible place. This is actually the Beach Boys' biggest selling song, Kokomo. That came way later, very late. It was in a movie. Down in Aruba, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take her down to Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama, Key Largo, Montego, ooh, I wanna take her down to Kokomo, we'll get there fast and then we'll take it slow, yeah, 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 Kokomo. I wanna catch a glimpse. The sax. The sax is grooving now. Saxophone. Staying up in the apex yoga groove. Apex yoga. The apex yoga groove. As a shirt, you know, that's an A, the A. What size is that on? There you go. The apex yoga groove. We're down to Coke, Aruba, Jamaica. Ooh, I wanna take her to Bermuda, Bahama. Come on, pretty mama. Key Largo, Montego. Ooh, I wanna take her down to Kokomo.
We'll get there fast and then we'll take it slow. That's where we wanna go. Whoa, Kokomo, Jamaica. Ooh, I wanna take her down to Bermuda, Bahama. Come on, pretty.
Doing a little harmonizing there, which I can do if I feel like it. If I get in the mood, like if I'm feeling the groove, you know, ooh, harmonizing.
It's automatic.
Yeah. So the groove of this world is to the groove of no groove in this world. Concretize. You got to be the concrete groove, the dead groove. You got to be in the dead groove. So we're all in the dead groove, man. We're in the cancer groove. So just accept that. Again, Thaddeus Golson, Lazy Man's Guide to Enlightenment, said, love it wherever you're at, just love it. Mean, realize that's a perfect groove too. Just as it is. That's a perfect groove. He's right. He was right. That was Apex Yoga. Thaddeus Golson sort of started the Apex Yoga thing in some way, you know, here in the West. Lazy Man's Guide to Enlightenment. And I recognized, I said, he's on to it. He's on to it. He's on to it. A lot of us recognize it. Unfortunately, he was not able to sustain it and clearly explain it because he got these insights. He took too many acid trips, you know. He got it on psychedelics and stuff. So it wasn't properly presented. Caused problems. Everybody thought they could get it. Oh, yeah, I can get it on psychedelics. And then he later on in life said, you know, maybe I was crazy. I was wrong and stuff. So, see, it didn't flower. Didn't flower. It's like artificial flower after. But you should have said, now I'm in the I don't get it groove. I didn't get it groove. I'm in the perfect I didn't get it right groove. Love that. Love that too. Oh, I was in the perfect groove of not getting it. The perfect groove. All right. That's Apex Yoga. I was in the perfect groove of not getting the perfect groove. It's all perfect. Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma says, everything's perfect right now. They said, hey, this is all messed up. She goes, what are you talking about? Everything's perfect. Everything's perfect. They said, why are you so happy all the time? There's all these troubles in the world. She goes, I don't see any troubles. I see just perfection everywhere. I see the perfect groove everywhere. You're all in the perfect groove right now. You're all in the perfect groove. You just are trying to doubt it. You're trying to doubt it. No song. A song of no song. It stopped. It did. It stopped. That's weird. It just stopped. It went back. Okay, that means I'm going to stop. 30 songs, 75 minutes. How do I turn this off? Okay. Off. There you go. It's off. That's off, it's off, it's off.
Ooh, this is the way I always dreamed it would be. The way that it is.
Yeah. When you are in the groove with me, you know. We're just like, this is the way we always dreamed it would be. We're in the groove, we're in the groove, we're in the groove, we're in the groove. We're in the perfect groove of now. Of always being in the perfect groove. Always being in the perfect groove. So, accept that we're in the... See, the reason why we don't accept that we're in the perfect groove right now is because our whole purpose is to doubt this. What we're trying to do is doubt it. So I say, no, the perfect groove is in the future. Which automatically means that it wasn't in the past. It makes a past out of now. There's a past where I wasn't in the future groove, in the perfect groove. See that? So we imagine that, so we make up time this way. Time is a duality to begin with. It's imagined duality. So I'm in the perfect groove right now. I'm always in the perfect groove. I'm in the perfect groove right now.
There's nothing but this perfect groove right now. Apex yoga. Be an apex yogin. But this intensive, we're going to do nothing but that. So this is the caveat here. So one caveat I have is I'm not going to deviate from it one bit if I can help it, right? I'm going to stay true to my groove here, because the mistake I made in the past was not being true to what I knew was true, and getting swept away, you know, like just like the Beatles, the Beach Boys and the Beatles commercially just devastated everybody, and instantly people just forgot about the Beach Boys, like, oh, it's the Beatles, the new kid in town, you know, they're so swinging, you know, swinging Londonish, and they're bringing all these drugs in too, this whole drug music came in, and people were ready to go for that. It's like a perfect storm, and all the drugs suddenly showed up. Was that just happenstance that the Beatles and availability of drugs sort of happened together? No, it wasn't happenstance. It was all socially engineered, actually. It's all done at a certain level of consciousness to bring it about. But the Beach Boys were just saying, do you want to dance and hold my hand? Tell me, baby, I'm your loving man. Oh, baby, do you want to dance? You know, they just, and like, it was beautiful music. And then they said, oh my gosh, we lost our audience. And so they said, what are the Beatles doing while they're taking drugs? You said drugs. So the Beach Boys, Brian Wilson said, well, I better start taking drugs to compete with them. You know, I gotta get our audience back. Not all the Beach Boys took drugs. I just say Brian Wilson, that was his thing, and he was very honest about it. He said, yeah, absolutely, I did. I did this and this and this, and I tried to compete. And it just screwed him up really bad. And they lost their vibe. They lost their groove, that particular groove that they had. Now they had a smiley smile groove. Pet Sounds is okay, half of it. But then it went downhill, you know, from there. They just absolutely lost their groove. And it just became some sort of self-indulgent, drug trippish, you know, blah. It's one of the saddest things. It just really devastated me. Really, to hear that, you know, I sort of lost my groove along with it, saying I've got to go along with the Beatles too, and I gotta, you know, follow that groove, because I otherwise I'll be completely, everyone will tell me I'm not in the groove anymore, I'm not groovy anymore. You lose all your friends, you lose your social cliques, you lose your, you know, generation stuff. But we still have the, you know, apex yoga groove, or apex yogin. So we've shifted out of generationalness here into yoginness, okay? And so, you see, this is very important to hear this. When you declare, I'm an apex yogin, I'm an apex yogin, and I do apex yoga, you're part of the apex yoga community now. Okay, you are part of the apex yoga community. So I'm going to experience this, what that's like. And so I'm kind of nervous about that. And you belong to that generation, the perpetually grooved generation. And so it doesn't matter when you were born. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter what generation you are. What your family is, what your friends are. You are part of the apex yogin community and culture. And you have access to it all now. It's like you're part of the hippie culture in San Francisco back in the day. You had access to, like, you know, the Fillmore and these parties and the these bands, and you knew, you know, what was happening, and you had an in to it all. And so you could rub shoulders with all these beautiful people, and, you know, you were part of it. So whenever you have some in, you get to meet these people who are part of that culture and community. If you're part of it, you get to meet those who are part of it. You're part of the culture. So, of course, they're part of the culture too. So meeting them is part of the experiencing that culture. And they're there to experience you. The fact that you're there in that culture. Because that's really cool for them. I mean, we all have our own flavor, don't we? We all have our own groove in our play and our dance of through eternity, and that delights us all. We all are delightful to one another, and so they're delighted that we're part of their community, the Apex Yoga community culture. They're delighted. And we all have that inner perpetually groovedness within us. So, you know, by declaring, okay, I am now an Apex Yoga, and that's what I am. That's what I am in terms of identification. In terms of identifying in this world, right now, I'm an Apex Yogin. Yogin. I'm a Yogin. Apex Yogin. Then this means, okay, and I'm waiting, you know, for that to start blossoming. Waiting and waiting. And as a symbol, you're just keep an eye on summer this year. Just keep an eye on summer. Great song by Beach Boys. I'm waiting and waiting. Fabulous song. It's not on this CD, but it's on, I think it's on one I have in my CD player, in my vehicle. Keep an Eye on Summer. Ah, what a great, great, great song. What a groove that is. Keep an Eye on Summer this year. And we should keep an eye on summer this year, because we're, at least for me, I'm an Apex Yogin. And I'm thrilled to be an Apex Yogin. I'm thrilled. I'm a newbie, but newbies are welcome. In fact, that's what grows Apex Yoga. So you don't think that they welcome a newbie in Apex Yoga? You better believe they do. I believe it. I haven't experienced what that's like yet. I mean, that's what they're all about, is they're searching for those who they can mature and bring into being an Apex Yogin. So when you get a newbie Apex Yogin, I mean, I don't know what they're doing now, but I bet they're really thrilled, you know, head over heels, just like, maybe I gave them a wow moment. maybe they're not responding right this moment because they're in the wow. Maybe Longchenpa's in the wow. I think he is. It's like, wow. Maybe he's just enjoying the wow of it. Yeah, why not? Wow, it's quite enjoyable. Because it's not easy to get to be an Apex Yogin, because it's so simple. It's so simple. You have to forego all the complexity. You have to be willing to drop all that complexity, and you're just in the simple, simple groove. That's it. It's a very simple groove. I think I'm going to get paged right now. Calling Apex Yogin, calling Apex Yogin. I stopped, you know, my main Facebook page because everybody's all over the map. You know, I'm not searching. I'm not in the marketplace like, I wonder what kind of groove I want to be in. Now, I know my groove. It's Apex Yogin groove. That's it. So I'm not interested right now in anything else. That's important. I let everybody have their groove. I smile to it. I love it all. But I have my groove, too. I'm not competing with anybody else. I'm not trying to be like somebody else. I'm not trying to go into some other direction. I'm not, you know, if some heavyweight comes along with a different style, that's fine. I'm going to keep this style for this year. I'm going to keep this style. And you know what? Some of those groups that kept their own style, their own groove, they're still performing, and you hear them now, and they sound great. You say, wow, you still have it. You still have that groove. That's awesome. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. I'm ready to collapse right now. Okay, so that feeling of exhaustion. Put a lot of energy into this video. And I was just having fun and just sort of breaking the ice. You know, it's just a lighthearted hors d'oeuvres, kind of. Just some few hors d'oeuvres, tossing out some chatter and some hors d'oeuvres before the main party starts. That's all. The Apex Yogan party. Wonder what kind of party they're going to throw me. I'll find out. Gonna find out now, right? Okay, very great. I'm gonna time to call it a day. I gotta get up early again, and holy cow. Whew. A lot of work, and it's gonna be raining like.